Hello students, I hope you are all well. Today in live class, we just did example number 4 and example number 5, okay? Before starting with this example, I want to inform you that your half yearly syllabus has been completed today, okay? Example number 4, I have already sent you its video earlier, okay, in the starting of this chapter. And today I will just complete example number 5, okay? Before starting with this question, I have some things to say to you. First of all, students, your examination will be of an objective type of paper. Okay, I hope you already know this. And objective types of papers usually contains direct calculations, direct questions, questions in which I can find out right answers. In objective MCQ type of question, I cannot in any way give you proof questions like we have discussed in this chapter. So what kind of questions will be coming from chapters these chapters 7 and 8? First of all, from chapter 7 and 8, you should focus on definitions as well as the statements in the questions of the questions. Statements we have used during the proof of a question that you should focus on, and the statements that of the question itself that you should focus on, okay? With regarding every chapter, I will be providing you with some assignment questions, MCQ questions. I will hope that you will do these questions timely. Now, from tomorrow onwards, we will start with the revision of this whole course. First of all, I will send you the video of coordinate geometry. In the meantime, I want all of you to gather your senses, to practice, to go through your syllabus, and kindly inform me if you have any special problem in any particular chapter. Okay, I have been informed already by one or two students that chapter number 2 last exercise is quite difficult. I know that. I understand that the student is requesting to focus on that exercise. So we will cover that exercise in short while. In the same manner, if you have a priority of any particular chapter that you want in your video or in live class, please inform me on my WhatsApp number that you already know, or you can find it in your school group. Okay. Second thing is, the assignment that I am going to send you on your WhatsApp group portal, okay, that assignment is quite important. I want all of you to go through that assignment, and if you have any particular questions or queries, kindly inform me so that I can include the solution of those questions in those assignments. Unlike we did in the previous exam where I explained each and every question of the assignment, this time I will only explain the problems that you ask me of. Once again, you have to ask me the problems in WhatsApp group. Okay, send me the question numbers, appropriate question numbers, and then I will provide you with the answers. Okay, and there is one more thing. One of the students has asked me exercise 8.1 question number 6. I want to inform that student that question number 6 solution is exactly as same as question number 1. Okay, question number 6 solution is exactly as same as question number 1. You do the same solution, and at the end of that solution you just write one line: since diagonals of parallelogram are equal, let me repeat the statement again. Since diagonals of a parallelogram bisect each other, therefore line joinings the opposite sides of rhombus are also bisector of each other. That's it. That is the last statement that you have to use. Otherwise, it is same as question number 1. If you have any difficulty, please review the video again. Okay. Now, let us start with question number 5. Okay, this is the only question that we are going to discuss today. Question number 5 is, we have to prove that this PQRS is a rectangle. We have to prove that this PQRS is a rectangle. Okay, ABCD is a given parallelogram, and we have to prove that quadrilateral formed by joining these angle bisector of this parallelogram will form a rectangle. So, in this question, we are going to use the approach in which we will prove that all the interior angles of this quadrilateral are right angles. In that manner, we will do two things. First of all, we will say that since both pair of opposite angles are equal, therefore it is a rectangle. Since angle S and angle Q are 90 degree, P and R are 90 degree, therefore both pair of opposite angles are equal, therefore PQRS will become a parallelogram. And since all the interior angles are 90 degree, therefore it is a rectangle. Okay, so this sort of proof we will do. For let us start with the proof. I will write down the given into proof. What is given to us is that in parallelogram ABCD, in parallelogram ABCD, AP, BP, CR and DR are angle bisectors of angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D respectively. Okay, next is to prove. What we need to prove is that PQRS is a rectangle. Let us start with the proof. Okay. Now, in this quadrilateral ABCD, in this parallelogram ABCD, we will use the concept of co-interior angles. Okay. So, what is the concept of co-interior angles? For two parallel lines, angles on the same side of the transversal are supplementary. Okay. So, first of all, we will start with, since DC line is parallel to AB, opposite sides of parallelogram, because these are opposite sides of parallelogram and they are supposed to be parallel, angle A plus angle D, complete angle A plus complete angle D should be equal to 180 degree, because these are pair of co-interior angles. These are pair of co-interior angles. Okay. Now, what I am going to do is, I am going to divide this whole equation by 2. That will be half of angle A plus half of angle D will be equal to 90 degree. Half of angle A and half of angle D will both be equal to 90 degree. Okay. Now, what I have proved that? Half of angle A is this angle, angle SAD, and half of angle D is angle, this angle, angle ADS. So, angle SAD plus angle ADS will be equal to 90 degree, marking it as equation number 1. Now we will move on to triangle ADS. In triangle ADS, sum of all the interior angles will be 180 degree. Angle S, let me write it down again, I've miswrote something. Angle SAD plus angle ADS. Angle SAD plus angle ADS plus angle DSA are all equal to 180 degree. This is angle sum property of a triangle. Angle sum property of a triangle. Okay. So, in this manner, we already know that the sum of angle SAD and angle ADS is 90 degree from equation 1, or 90 degree plus angle DSA is equals to 180 degree. Angle DSA, value of angle DSA will be 180 degree minus 90 degree, that is 90 degree. Angle DSA is equal to 90 degree. Okay. So, in this manner, we have determined that value of angle DSA, this is this angle is 90 degree. Now, observe students, at point S, let me enlarge the diagram for you. At point S, the angles vertically opposite to each other should be equal. That means if angle DSA is 90 degree, angle PSR should also be 90 degree. At point S, angle PSR is equals to angle DSA is equals to 90 degree. Because both are pair of vertically opposite angles. Okay. So, in this manner, we have proved that this angle S is 90 degree. Similarly, we will prove that angle Q, angle PQR is also 90 degree. So, we will write down similarly, okay, and similarly, after writing similarly, you will do all these steps, how so, DC is parallel to AB, do not write down any of the reasons, DC is parallel to AB, and then angle C plus angle B is 180 degree, here you will write angle C plus angle B is 180 degree. Half of angle C plus angle B is 90 degree, and then angle QCB plus angle CQB is equals to 90 degree, and then you will move on to triangle CQB. In triangle CQB, these two angles are 90 degree. This angle will be, third angle will be again 90 degree, and vertically opposite angles are equal. Interior angle of angle Q, that is angle PQR, will be 90 degree. Similarly, after doing all this, you will have angle PQR is equals to angle CQB is equals to 90 degree. This will be your second equation. This will be first equation. This will be second equation. Okay. Now, let me take this diagram to the second page, because there are two more 90 degrees yet to be proved. Now, what we are going to do, see. Sorry. Now, we are going to move on to triangle DRC. Okay. I am going to take this triangle, triangle DRC, this is point R, this is D and this is C. In this triangle, I will prove that angle R is 90 degree. Okay. So, what will say in triangle DRC, angle RDC plus angle RCD plus angle R are all equal to 180 degree, angle sum property, and angle RDC is half of angle D plus half of angle C plus angle R, this is C, is equals to 180 degree. Half of angle D plus half of angle C will be equal to 90 degree. plus angle R is equals to 180 degree. Once again, we are not writing down the same solutions again and again, same reasons again and again, because this is kind of a repetitive question. So therefore, angle R will also be equal to 90 degree. And finally, you will write down similarly, angle P will also be equal to, sorry, I wrote 180 by mistake, angle P will also be equal to 90 degree. Okay. So in last, we will write down just one statement. Since all the interior angles of PQRS are right angles, thus PQRS is a rectangle. Okay, so in this manner you have PQRS is a rectangle. I hope you understood this question. Once again, I am not going to give you solution of question number 6 of exercise 8.1. And secondly, kindly inform me about the chapter that you want to do the revision first of all. First of all will be coordinate geometry. There is no argument about that. Secondly, about those assignments that I am going to provide to you, you have to do those assignments regularly. If you want to do in your homework copy, do in your homework copy, but that assignment is not a homework for me. That assignment, wo jo assignment hai, wo aapke liye homework nahi hai. That is not necessarily a homework for you. Aap kisi bhi copy mein kar sakte hain. I am not obliged to check that. Main usko check pe nahi karne wala. Apne hisab se kijiye. That assignment is very important from your examination point of view and your understanding point of view. आपको चैप्टर सही से समझ में आया है या नहीं आया है ये आपको असाइनमेंट से पता चलेगा. ओके, वो असाइनमेंट कीजिए. अगर उसमें कोई प्रॉब्लम आता है काइंडली इन्फॉर्म मी सो दैट आई कैन रेक्टिफाई योर प्रॉब्लम्स. ओके, सो थैंक यू फॉर योर टाइम. हैव अ नाइस डे.